turn around, and they'll make maggot meat out of you. Oh, there's nobody behind you. It's me. I'm in front of you, and your TV set. Oh, it's Freddy. Hello, Freddy. Have you brought me a message from Jeepers? What does he say? Good. You're going to hop on down to George Allen Rambler. Good. And what does he say about me? Tell me. Oh, yes. He still loves me, but he hasn't sent me my greasy gopher guts. Oh, Freddy, you better hop on down to George Allen Rambler. That's it. I wonder if there's movie stars at George Allen Rambler. You know, I was a movie star once. I was in the best pictures, and I used to get lots of fan mail. Oh, those were the ghoul old days. And Jeepers gets all the fan mail now, but like this one. Dear Jeepers, this letter is to notify you that the Grotesque Ghoul Society has just chosen you as Ghoul of the Year. Also, I've chosen you as my number one boyfriend. Oh. Well, I must admit it wasn't my idea, it was my mummy's. You see, she always says when she sees you, there's your boyfriend. Naturally, this slightly angers me, so I immediately chop off her head. And this happens every week, and she's beginning to look a little silly now because she only has two heads. Yes, I'm insanely in love with you, Jeepers, and every time I see you with your ghoul friend's skull, Doris, I nearly die, and my heart just splits in two. This can become a little messy, and I wouldn't want to get blood all over because I just had my cell freshly padded. That could be messy. Jeepers, if you read this on your program, I'll tell you a deep, dark secret. I reveal who's been playing all those dirty tricks on you. Have you ever awakened, finding yourself fully embalmed? And spikes driven through your chest? You have? Well, this is the works of those people that don't like you. Well, I didn't know there were people like that. I'm sure you do like Jeepers, and Jeepers will be glad to know what you've told me. Until I see you next week, I remain Tammy Tamberlane from Granada Hills. Thank you, Tammy. Now we'd better get back to our picture. Oh, wait a minute. I told you, one of you turned around, maggot meat.
Got some tanner leaves tonight because I'm going to try to get me a mummy because the movie I'm showing is The Mummy's Curse. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, great tanner leaves. Mungo, jingo, mambo lummy. Please, oh, please, great tanner leaves. Bring me a big white mummy. Tanner leaves, smanner leaves, they don't work. I don't know what kind of a sucker I am. Can't get a mummy with Annalise. Well, all I wanted is a little old mummy. Well, if I can't get a mummy with the tanner leaves, let's at least look at tonight's movie, The Mummy's Curse. I'm certainly a failure getting a mummy. But this, at least, isn't a failure. I've tried and tried to get a mummy with these tanner leaves. I don't know what I'm going to do. Why, if this man is my witness, everyone can see that you can't get a mummy with tanner leaves. You can't get a mummy. A mummy! Come on, mummy. At least stop joking me till this commercial is over. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. You're such a nice, friendly mummy. You're so friendly. I want to introduce you to my family. This is Doris, and this is Boris, and this is Sally Snake. Isn't she pretty? And this mummy is Julie. And this is Aunt Minnie. But look, this is Buck. There you are, Pumpkin. I can see that you like my family. You can see you like me too. While we get better acquainted, let's look at more of the mummy's curse. Mummy, you're so exhausted, I'm going to give you some tanner tea. By the way, here's something that's also exhausted. Isn't this tanner tea good, Mummy? Mummy, wait, I'll read your fortune. I'll read your fortune in the tanner leaf. I'm very good at reading tannerly fortunes. Let me see now. I see that you're going to have a great career. Yes, a great career in the Metropolitan Museum. You may be a star in the movies. Yes, maybe. Let me see now. Star in the movies. Yes, you might very well become a great Hollywood personality. Yes, you. If you just watch some more of The Mummy's Curse, you'll see how to act. Mummy, I'm going to make a few telephone calls to some producers and some talent scouts to see if I can't get you in the movies. But first we have to listen to this piece of talented information. Of course, you understand, Mummy, that the producers today aren't as great as I was when I was in my prime. But I know them all. Stay calm now. Wait now. in the big tent. Hello? Daryl! Daryl, you old fox! Daryl, are you making any movie?
Oh.
Well, would you consider making a movie? I have a wonderful new character. Yes, this is Jeepers. This is a mummy. Oh, you lost a lot of money on another Egyptian move. Oh, well, never mind, Daryl, never mind. I'll try another one. They gone now. They gone. Mankey. Oh, Mankey! The Jeepers! Yes, I have a wonderful new star for you. Yes, a mummy. Oh. You're looking for a girl who looks like Cleopatra to play Elizabeth Taylor's life. Oh, you wouldn't be interested in a mummy then. Oh, well, never mind, there's always Alfred. Stay calm. Stay calm now. Jeepers knows how to do this. These fools. Fools, they sometimes don't know talent, you know. Not everyone can have a mummy with tunnelies. Hello. Hello, Alfred. Yes, Alfred. I have a wonderful loop. How did you know it was a mummy? Oh, you can use the mummy. Oh, that's wonderful, Alfred. There must be a hitch to it, huh? There isn't any hitch to it. But you won't be shooting again this year. Well, we'll try next year. Just all right. Goodbye, Alfred. Goodbye. Well, there's always the producer of that funny thing. I don't know. You know, the strange thing, Sunset Zone, something. What do you mean this is a recording? Forget it. Oh, mummy, don't worry now. Don't worry. I have one more, I know. Oh, my friend, I almost forgot my friend. It's John Barrymore, you know. Hello, John. John, is that you? Yes, Jeepers, here. I have a new piece of talent. Yes, I know you're dead, but never mind. Well, mummy, I didn't pay the bill. When you're a big and famous star like I am, mummy, you'll get fan mail too. And I have a letter here from me, Jimmy Fox of San Diego. I'll read it to you after this infamous message. Jimmy Fox's letter reads, Dear Jeepers, I just love your bloodthirsty show. It gives me that gory feeling. Also, it gives me time to go killing with my friends. Please excuse my writing, because when I was making a toy guillotine, I chopped off a few fingers. Yes. Doris is cute with her bleached white skull and her hair. Oh, it's nice. Blood-colored red. What the hell do? I wish I had such a charming girlfriend. My girlfriend is ugly. She never likes what I bring home to eat. Not even if I brought her barbecued gopher's liver with sprinkled lizard cells and fish eyes. So I decided to get rid of her for good. So I walled her up in the basement. And she hasn't complained yet. You are so handsome with your top hat, me, you know, and your long, straggly hair, and that is why I'm dying to get your picture. Oh, yes, the picture. Horridly yours, Jimmy Fox. Yes. Have a scary good night, Jeepers. Well, same to you, Jimmy Fox of San Diego. And thank you for your letter. Remember, we read one each week. And if you'd like my picture, my anteater will put one in the envelope and lick the envelope and send it off to you. Oh, she's really working overtime on them, she is, that anteater. Oh, but, Mummy, let's get back now and look at some more of our movie, The Mummy's Curse. Now, Mummy, if I'm going to make you into a big movie star, you'll have to get your beauty rest. Could use it, too. Now, you go to bed in your coffin and get some rest, some nice beauty rest. Good night, Mummy, whoever you are. Well, you see, everybody knows you can't make a mummy. It was just a piece of trickery that I learned when I was making my great Hollywood horror movies. So be with us again next week when we will present a wonderful movie with Boris Karloff, Before I Hang. Oh, no, Mummy. Mummy, you can't make a mummy with Donnelly. No.
Persistent monsoon that moans in the night, its breath a searing flame from the bowels of the underworld, carries on its breast an urgent plea from the quintillions of lost souls that roam the shadow world of that dark dimension. And this message vibrates serpentine-like up a royal, across desolate wastelands, through the oily waters of the amphibian-infested swamps, over the crest of the ice-capped peaks, and down to the blasted hearth to shriek in our attentive audio receptacles that the hour for nightmare is once again at hand. And what a succulent morsel of good fortune that we were ever at the ready for such a thing, video feeds. For a real blood-icer, bone-brittler of a cinema is about to flicker to life on your television screens. It is called The Frozen Ghost. And guess who stars in it? Boris? No. Baylor? No. But I'll give you a little hint. If a thing is frozen, it is bound to be stiff. Now, who is the stiffest actor in the universe? Huh? Right! Lon Chaney Jr., the most horrible horror thespian ever to don grease paint of unearthly hue and plastics of a natural born. By the warlocks of Wapsahatchee, what are you doing, Rodney? What? You rude roustabout. Rodney, turn that blasted thing down. You hear me? Rodney, have you capitulated to the adolescent philosophy of rebellion without cause? Have you?
But it serves you well enough, Rodney. You're getting so flaccid, show-offish about everything. Huh. Now you just plop your young flanks down on that chair a minute, fresh sprig. It's time you and I had a monster-to-monster talk. Straight from the shoulder, so to speak. Anatomically, that is. Let me confide in you, good girl. Has ever a bond of an eagle ship ever known such continual assault and strain wrought by this callow clogged vacillating taste? It is indeed a caution, and it requires the most assiduous of directions to lead him from these extremist tangents. Well, while I map my campaign, you troops bivouac by your TV sets to perceive the first act of the Frozen Ghost.
Good evening. The persistent monsoon that moans in the night carries on its breath an urgent plea from the quintillions of lost souls that roam the shadow world of a darker dimension. And this message vibrates across desolate wastelands, through the muck of amphibian-infested swamps, and over the crest of ice-shrouded peaks, and down to this blasted heath to shriek. Nightmare is once again at hand.
Ooh. Oh, trembling Tyrannosaurus. What a succulent morsel of good fortune it is that we are at the ready for another stingerino of a talking picture, such as we have for you tonight. Eh, Rodney?
By the warlocks of Wapsahatchee, what's going on, Riley?
She thought my name was Gary. I told her it was Gary. She said she didn't like me.
Well, you rude rhinoceros!
She said you left the Mary.
Turn that thing off, Riley! Turn it off!
Zooks,
you arrogant boardwalk. What you mean is this? Is this another terrifying example of the degeneration gap? Is it?
Huh? His daughter's name is Sherry. His son's a Tom and Jerry.
Well, it serves you right, Riley. You pushy mob. Now listen, put that thing down. Get that off of there. Turn it off. Just put it down there, and you plop your young flanks down on that stool, because, Rodney, it is time you and I had another monster-to-monster talk. Huh? Let me ask you, good ghouls, has ever a bond of camaraderie known such continual assault and strain? All wrought by this Kurt Claude's vacillating lifestyle. Well, whilst I map my campaign to reform his rapid mood swings, you troops bivouac by your TV sets for the first act of our titillating tale of terror. Roar.
Nightmares brought to you in part by Air Capital Comics and Games, with a great selection of old and rare comics. And by Coca-Cola. You can't beat the feeling.
calling all stations. Clear the air lanes, clear all air lanes for the big broadcast.
Ah, there's trouble in the old corral tonight as a vampire invades the early west in Curse of the Undead. Who could stop a vampire in those lawless days of the old, whatever you want to call it?
A fiery hearse with the speed of fright, a cloud of cigar smoke, and a hearty, hi-yo Tupperware! The Bone Ranger rides again with his faithful Indian companion, Scripto. The boring and repulsive masked rider of the Dan Ryan fights for law and order in the early west.
Irwin!
Ah, Kimoslabi, what do you make of situation?
Well, Scripto, this looks like the work of the beef jerky gang.
Them plenty tough. Plenty tough.
I hope we haven't bitten off more than we can chew.
Why don't you two follow the trail of commercials and meet me back here at the end of the movie? Roll Curse of the Undead, will ya? Roll the movie.
Me hope movie not too violent.
Why, Scripto?
Violent.
Violence?
Violence bad. That's where Scripto draw the line. Scripto. Kimosloppy, tell me something. Why birds suddenly appear every time you draw near?
Just like me, they long to be close to you.
Tough crowd, Kimosloppy.
Shut up, will you?
Roll movie, attack of monsters. Me, go to town now, Kimosloppy.
Do you believe this, a vampire in the Old West?
Isn't that pitiful?
Do you remember a former werewolf who made it big in the West?
Sean Cassidy.
No, it was young Michael Landon who started in I Was a Teenage Werewolf, but then went Western and starred in Bonanza and Little House on the Prairie. So former Wolfman Michael Landon's success out West came simply from getting a shave.
Pepe's got the right idea, cause a fellow wolf man will never forget Mike Landon's first big hit, the love theme from I Was a Teenage Werewolf, or Get a Shave.
In the 50s to get the part, my agent said, before you start, get a shave. Any actor who's in demand is clean cut and has a tan to get into movies, man. One werewolf movie, then shaved my whole face clean. That pulled me from movies to TV when I was adopted by Lauren Green. Now I've got no cause to grouse, I star in Little House.
Out there on the prairie, no need to be scary since the shave.
Now another saddle sore story from Tombstone's Tales of the Old West.
Irwin.
I said Old West, not Near West. I was tending bar in the Skokie Lagoon Saloon, serving a shot of red-eye to the man who keeps things nailed down in this town, when the local crusty but benign old codger ambled in all a twitter.
There's a big trouble brewing, partner. That ghoulie kids are riding into town and he's looking for you.